This video explains in some detail how to embed via our iframe. So typically an iframe or script based embed is used in a say an HTML page or some say third party site. Suppose you are creating a site but it is not entirely coded from your backend in a language, but it is through some other portal, through some other LMS site. Okay, then how to integrate within it via an iframe or script. So firstly, if video is ready in your dashboard, you click on the embed button and then you choose the quick embed section. In the quick embed section, it shows you the video ID. You are asked to put an expiry time for the URL. So by default, it is at 30 years, so you can change it. So suppose you want to keep it for say 1 year. Okay. 12 months or whatever. Then secondly, it asks you for a whitelist option. Suppose you have a site, whatever, like my site.com, etc. So don't use any HTTPS, etc. Don't use any www, just the main URL, which is like mysite.com, okay, or whatever you have, okay, mysite.jp, whatever site you have, just put it without any HTTPS or slash, etc. Okay, so for this demo, I'm not putting any site for now. Then if you want to geo or country restrict, then there is some country code which you can get it from here link. For example, for USA, it is US. For India design, so you can put it. So typically it is not needed, it is more needed for movie creators. If they need it, then they can check the country code and they can put it here. So it would be come into the whitelisting of the allowed countries. So once you have put the URL, okay, and if you needed a country and you set the expiry time, so you need to click on the generate embed code. Okay. So there is an optional feature to add watermark to the video. So let us try to add watermark. I'm skipping the whitelist for now. So in the watermark section, you can see that it has three things primarily: a static, a fixed text, an IP, and a time. Okay, so you can change this text, say 2019 copyright. You can disable time if you don't want the IP. Whatever you want, you can do that. You can change that size, opacity, transparency of this watermark. The size is the size of the watermark, so it would be same for all the IP, time, etc. text. Opacity is if you do it one, it is very dark. If it is 0.06, it is very light. Color is a hex code of the color. So if you want to change the color, you can change the hex code. You can search on Google for what hex code of any color you want is. Okay. And this is skip between. So suppose you don't want the watermark to be showing every time. So if you say, suppose set it for 20 seconds, it will not show for 20 seconds in between. This is move interval, so the watermark changes position. So it is a moving watermark. So if you want it to be remaining at a one pace and then move, so you can change it. So suppose if I do it, say 6 seconds. So it means it will stay at a position for 6 seconds, then move. But now I have added a 6, so it will stay at a position for around 6 seconds. It will not show for 19 seconds and then it will move. Please note that these intervals and skip, they are not based on the timeline of the video. So suppose, let's check a video. Suppose we have a video here. So it is not based on this timeline that till 20 seconds or 5 seconds. So this is just based on an experiential timeline. So if I am say watching here, anywhere here, whatever time we have. So when the watermark is showing, then the watermark will behave in a way that it will not show for about 19 seconds and then it will show. It will change positions every, it will stay in one position for 6 seconds and then change positions. Okay, so this is not based on timeline of the video, but it is based on a user time. This is it. So you can click on generate embed code after putting the whitelist and the watermark code. One thing is there is a JSON option here. So if you click on the JSON, you can see that this is also mentioned in the text. Now suppose you wanted that you want different color for different watermarks. So for IP you want something different. So you can change it here actually. Okay, so you can change it here. Okay, so JSON code is actually configurable much more. Now also JSON code is helpful. You can just copy this JSON code. Now next time when you are generating an iframe for a different a video, then you can just copy paste this JSON. Suppose I'm generating here, okay, and I'm generating some other embed code, okay. So there, instead of just setting everything what I want, I just go to the JSON section, I remove it, and just put the previous JSON which I had copied from it. So that JSON section is helpful in much more detailed editing and also copy pasting directly. Okay. So after you have set this, you click on the generate embed code. You see there is, you also can make the player responsive. You can click on here if you want to make the player responsive. So you see there is a note here, for HTML5 player to work instead of flash, your site domain should be in HTTPS or you should be testing on this local host. So this is very, very important. So we play DRM encrypted secure content. So this is a requirement by browser, not by VdoCipher, that the DRM encrypted content can only play on a live site if the site is on HTTPS. If you're testing in local host, then it is also fine. But if there is a live site, then it can't be an HTTP to play HTML5 secure content, it needs to be an HTTPS. Now I just copy this iframe code, so there is a copy to clipboard option. Now copied this iframe. Okay, similarly you can copy the script. So in certain pages script can work, so if script can work, it is better because there are certain things which are more customizable in script on the later stage if somebody is on the development side. But in many cases for small medium businesses, if they are not much into development, the simple thing is to just copy paste the iframe. So this, I have copied the iframe. Now I will try to put it in different kind of HTML pages to explain you how it works and what are the common issues which people face while embedding it. So firstly, this is a simple WordPress page. So in WordPress, actually our short code is better, but just I'm showing it to explain how it works. Okay. So it is always recommended to put the iframe in the code editing section of any site. Any site, any LMS site, any third party site or your site. There must be a visual section, there would be a text section. So text section, for example, in a WordPress text section, I put it here. Okay, I'll just try this, etc. And okay. Now you see this code is pasted here. Please note this allow full screen through and allow encrypted media. Please note this section, allow encrypted media. So this is very important. This should always remain in the iframe. If you copy it directly from our site, it is there. Now when I do it, when I just check this video, you see the video is playing fine.
We have done videos on basic upload, embed, etc. So firstly, the important things are, if you click on embed
and
button,
and the watermark which you had configured, copyright, etc. that are also
which
showing
which is
here.
Actually main reference.
It is also currently small. Let me just increase its size. So suppose for a demo, just I'm increasing the size. Now you say just
we
for a demo, the
right?
So it is playing fine. Now you
see
what is the issue here. Now there is no issue here, so it is playing fine with whatever settings we have applied. But now let's see another thing. So I am taking some time to explain this because I have seen that many people are facing this problem. Suppose I go to the visual section of the WordPress. Okay, you see it has showing a little of flash, and then just I update it. Now if I go to the same page, you see it has started asking me flash. Just back it played without flash, now it is asking flash. Why is it so? Let's look at the page editor again. What happens when you go to visual section of WordPress or many sites is that the actual code, if you can go back to the text section to see what happened with the actual code. You see that I had mentioned in allow encrypted media content, so that is removed here. So many themes, plugins, etc. trend to remove that code. So that is why it has got deflected. So it is always good to finally paste the embed code in the text section and or the code editor section and then do the final update. Suppose you had many text and many images, etc. in this page. So do everything first, okay? So you can do those things from say visual section only, okay? For example, I have to write something and something. Whatever I have to do, I do it. Then finally, before publishing, okay, I go to the text section. Wherever I want the video, I just put the iframe and then I click on the update button. So the final update is from the code or the text section of the editor, any editor. For example, this is WordPress editor, but any editor. So if I play here, now my video is again playing fine in HTML5 page. A good way to know whether it is playing in HTML5 is, firstly, it doesn't ask for permission of flash, and also HTML5 player has a speed change option. So flash player doesn't have a speed change option. Okay. Let us look at another common example of embedding an iframe. So most of you would be using a third party site, maybe LMS site. For example, I have opened a trial account on Teachable. So Teachable is a popular course selling site. So if you go to the Teachable dashboard, then it has sections of creating content. In the dashboard, so there is a way where you can configure courses, etc. Then you can also configure website. So I've opened it just a course editor of a Teachable site. So where I am going to new lecture and creating a new lecture. So don't go to the add file section and start adding your video, because that will play via the default Teachable setup. Okay, go to the add code section and then just paste the iframe here as well. Okay, so don't click on display source, just put the normal iframe directly in the normal add code section and click on save. And then go to the preview section. Or whatever, you can publish it. So I had also tried another code. So you can see that our video is playing fine with the HTML secure playback. And if you had put the whitelist, it will only play on this particular domain. So this way you can embed in any third party site, okay? Teachable also has a site editing option where you can edit the page site, etc. So there also similarly in the pages you can add our video if you want to. So for example, I have added a similar iframe. So it also works on the Teachable page. So whether you are directly configuring your Teachable course through creating new lectures or you are configuring the pages of Teachable, in the both cases our iframe works well, and you can place secure DRM encrypted plus watermark videos through Teachable by using video iframe. But so keep as a summary, keep these things in mind. So do ensure that your domain is in HTTPS. Do ensure that in our embed code the text allow encrypted media is not being removed by any theme. So it is always good to finally push the content from the code editor section. So here it was mentioned as add code. In many of the sites, this is typically mentioned as something like in this symbol or say HTML editor or text section. So like there are editors which show different things, but all of them have HTML editor section mentioned differently. So you just have to put the iframe there and publish it from there. It will work well. Thank you.